Hey guys, Dr. Chris Miller here with Chirosports Specialist. Dr. Grant gave you an introduction to foam rolling, so this is going to be our protocol videos. Now I'm going to break them apart into two videos, an upper and a lower, so it's easier to follow and they don't get too long. So grab your foam roller. I'm going to talk as we go. We're going to start rolling the hip. So just a couple reminders. One, don't roll in a linear motion, roll in a circular motion, because that hits more cross area of the muscle. If you find a spot that's tender, just put some pressure down. Hold for a second. And remember, each area you want to roll about 30 seconds to a minute. Okay, so from there, I'm going to turn the foam roller out. I'm going to cross my leg over. So this is going to hit the deeper muscles of the hip, like the piriformis. Again, rolling in a circular motion. If I find a tender spot, put some pressure. Okay, from there, we're going to do the hamstrings. Notice how I cross my leg over? That's going to just use some more weight. If you don't need to, you could just roll like this. I need some extra weight. Okay, so these bigger muscles, break them apart into two spots. Do the upper part, then do the lower part. That way you don't miss anything. So I'll roll the upper, make sure you hit the inside and the outside, and then lower, inside, outside. Now you don't want to roll directly on the back side of the knee, you want to roll just above it, just below it. Okay, let's go down in the calf, same thing. Break apart into two spots, upper, inside, upper, outside. Now when you get into this lower part of the calf, middle to lower, you find a tender spot, watch my bottom leg, do some active mobilizations there as you put pressure. And then keep rolling. Find another spot, do some active stretching. So that's going to be more effective. Okay, from there I'm going to flip, do my quads. The same thing, break apart into two sections, do the upper and then do the lower. Make sure you hit inside and outside. So quad means four, so there's a lot of muscles there to roll. Okay, so same thing, and if you find a tender spot, you can do some active. Now it takes a little bit to get your coordination. And then one other thing I wanted to mention here. We don't advise rolling right on the outside on the IT band because it's a sensitive structure. It's got a lot of nerves and you can irritate it. However, the upper outer part is muscular, called the TFL. You want to roll right directly on the hip bone, but right on the front of it, there's a little muscle. You can roll on that. Okay, so here's a bonus. Lacrosse ball or tennis ball. My favorite for getting in that deep muscle in the hip, like I said, the piriformis. However, this gets in there pretty good, so you gotta be careful because you've got sciatic nerve and some other structures that you can irritate if you're too aggressive. Okay, bonus number two, tiger tail. It's my favorite tool for the calf because you don't have to balance and hold yourself up. So I really like this one for getting in the calf. You can hit the outside of the leg and you can hit the front of the shin if you have shin splints. You can also hit the other muscles too as well, but it's my favorite for the calf and then the lower leg. So that's our lower extremity protocol for foam rolling. Now just a couple more things with foam rolling. It's a warm-up tool, but you could also use it for recovery. So after a workout, just quick flush the muscle out. You could also use it on your off days, but treat it like a massage. You wouldn't want to get a massage every day because your muscles need recovery. So just a good protocol. You know, if you work out three times a week, it's good to do three times a week, but you can do it up to five times. Just not something you want to do every day. So tag somebody in this video that needs to foam roll. Thanks for listening. And our next video is going to be the upper extremity protocol.